So then, the warm-up session is complete. Hopefully, the FPS problem I was having earlier, hopefully it's cleared up now, but we will see.
Yeah, and then we are looking forward to two nice races.
Yes, okay then. So the first race then with Govac on our pole position. Oh, I've got someone behind me as well. I get nervous when that happens. Right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Wind them up and let him go. Crikey, that was quick. Alright, quick. To the front they go. Quick. And Govac has hung on to the lead. No, he hasn't. He's lost the lead. Blimey, he's lost two positions already. Today in Fizzy. What a start Fizzy's had. Crikey, he's getting over his starting problems, it seems, as Fizzy goes through turn one and two in the lead with Manu on his gearbox. What a start. Goodness me, and I'm trying to change camera, but my interface isn't letting me. Right, Manu on his tail then. Govac down to third place as they come round the 180 degree turn of turn four. Worn tyre holding fourth place. DBZ Leica 5L, Nano 6, Hideaki 7, SMVZ 8, Vice Guy up to ninth place, and Jozza's holding 10th.
And one tyre spun behind
the guys. Oh, so he's going to lose a lot of positions. Fizzy leading that train of three as they come down towards... I've actually lost track. Where are they? That's terrible of me. Oh, they're coming down to turn 10. So Fizzy currently leads. That is going to be a difficult battle for Fizzy to defend for 20 laps. We will see what happens now. I believe that there were some concerns over tyre wear again. So we may be seeing people having to pit because the tyres are not going to hold.
Definitely. This track is known for its tire killing abilities.
Particularly the front left, I believe.
Yeah.
Manu has spun! Unforced error. He had Govac right on his gearbox quite a way.
Too much pressure.
But Manu has decided? He's managed to hold on to third place. Worn tyre is still in fourth. Or he's reclaimed fourth position. I didn't really see what happened to him particularly as I was concentrating on the front three. That gives Fizzy a bit of breathing room then, but not a great deal. Govac right behind him. Manu now with distance in between. Oh, and that's Esteban Viso with a wonderful outside overtake maneuver at turn four. But Warn Tyre's not given up on that. Oops, there's my... Oh, I beg your pardon. My interface is going utterly mad.
The camera is really, really bad on this.
The camera is terrible on this track. I do apologize for people watching my recording. Hideaki's spinning. Oh, what a hell, sir. He actually had that sideways there through. Again, I've lost track on what corner we're on because the camera is jittering around so much. That's turn seven. Hideaki was slightly sideways there, holding off Esteban Viso.
Oh, and another crash in the P89 Stokemon. Crashed into the barrier very hard.
Oh no, is that the end of Stokeman's race? I wonder. I'm actually looking at the lead go at possible lead change. Govac has closed right in on Fizzy. So coming around. Oh, Govac's gone too wide in that turn 14-15 complex there. That gives Fizzy again a bit of breathing room. But how long for? Govac's really presenting quite a challenge here. I'm going to remind our viewers that these are default setups they are using. These are not tuned setups for the driver's style, but wow, does it seem to be working for Govac.
Again, we have someone making up more than 10 positions within one lap. This is Wise Guy this time.
Oh, what a stunning start. Oh, Govac nearly going too wide there on the long turn three. Come down into turn four. And my camera's staring at the road again.
Damn you.
Oh, the cameras are awful on this track. Goodness me, I thought Road America was bad. So then, I'm going to chance looking down the field, see what's what. Manu in third place. Worn Tyre in four. Can see the podium positions ahead of him. Hideaki four in fifth place. Oh, he's had Esteban Viso somewhere. But Viso's right on his tail. Could we see fifth place change hands? Not just yet. Oh, just as I say that! Yes, Manviso had a run on Hideaki, but no, Hideaki held that off perfectly well. Jozza's currently 7. Mr. DBZ Leica's EV falling through the field in 8th position. DJ Ballistics in 9. And there is the aforementioned Vice Guy rounding out your top 10.
Back up. Right on the tail of Fizzy now.
Yeah, just jump back up to this lead battle. Oh, that is so close. So that's the final turn they just come to. Fizzy, literally a car's length, not even that between the two. Is Govac going to have a go? Yes, he's going to go for an outside maneuver. Fizzy defending the inside line, but no, Govac thinks better of it. Turn two. Oh, they're leaving Manu behind. It's Manu spun or some such. It's quite a big gap between second and third there. I didn't see did they have a problem, but he may have, or he may simply be just be struggling with this particular circuit. I think he did hint the fact that he may not be quite as hard on Fizzy on this track as previous. So instead of Manu, it's new guy Govac that is pressuring here. I'm sure if we ask Govac what flavour chewing gum Fizzy is chewing, Govac could probably tell us. I daren't look away. I want to see what else is going on in the rest of the field, but I daren't, because they are so close and there's such a long way to go in this race. Oh, who's that that spun? You keep an eye on the front battle. Oh, Govac has gone wide. Govac has given Fizzy a bit of room. I'm going to see if I can find out who that was that spun. I left it too late. Oh, one tyre has overtaken Manu. One tyre has claimed Manu. Manu's really struggling with the track here today. I don't think he's damaged. I don't think Manu's hit anything. It just seems that this track is not suiting Manu at all. One tyre has taken third. It's got himself a little bit of a gap.
I can only imagine that he must have collected some damage somewhere down the last laps.
Now it's interesting. Hideaki 4 is showing in fourth position. Where's Manu gone?
And Esteban Wiese trying to overtake Hideaki, but no, that was not enough.
I think that must be Flying K-Man that I just saw there. Spawn. Ah! Damn this interface! Oh, there's Manu, he's in seventh! Manu is in seventh position, crikey, he really has come a cropper there. They're actually lapping K-Man already, so K-Man really has had a horrific start to this race. Can Manu make up some positions? Joss is now in 6th position. And can he fend off the ever-charging Manu? Viso, as previously mentioned, in 5th position. Hideaki 4 still holding off Esteban. One tyre on his own in 3rd position. Govac still misses in 2nd, and my camera's no idea where he is. There we go. A little bit of a gap now between Fizzy and Govac, but what a battle this is transpiring to be.
I think Fizzy now found his pace. He can keep a certain gap to Govac.
He's gotten into his rhythm a bit. So 128.066 is Govac's best, and 128.311 is Fizzy's best. So there's 0.3 to Govac's favour as far as that's concerned. But Govac has made a few errors in this race, and Fizzy's holding onto the pressure well. May we be seeing another win under Fizzy's belt? Very early to be calling that. 15 laps of this circuit to go. One tyre on his own, third position. Esteban Viso has claimed fourth now. Where's Hideaki gone? Manu's up to fifth place. He's taking.
He missed that. Hideaki down to 10th position.
Oh, goodness me, because Manu's up 11th. Manu's up to 5th place now, DBZ like is 6th, so we've lost a few people there. DJ Ballistics up to 7, Vice Guy's now up to 8th position, he was 10th last time I looked at him. Stokeman 9, IGC 2 is now up to 10th place.
Joss is retired.
Ah, Joss is, yes, he has mysteriously vanished. Back up to the front then. Fizzy still holding a narrow gap from Govac. Where are they currently? That's coming up to turns 14 and 15. God, blimey. This is going to be a real test to see how well Fizzy can hang on to the pressure, or handle the pressure rather, being presented by Govac.
And today just got back before, as one tyre seems to have made a mistake or something.
That he has, yeah, he's fallen 2 positions. Esteban Viso now up to 3rd place. Excellent effort for him. My camera's going utterly mad now, trying to pick up people. And Fizzy has definitely gone into rhythm. Govac could be saving his tyres a bit. As we previously mentioned, this circuit is quite unkind to tyres, so it could be that they're settling into a rhythm, playing the longer game here. Still 14 laps to go, still a long way to go in this race. Kovac. Esteban Viso now got Manu not far behind him at all.
Nope.
Wontai is not out, touch either. He can close that gap down. EBZ Leica. Gap.
Oh, and Kovac again trying to overtake Pisi.
Oh, my game went really bananas. I could see the wheels and nothing more for a brief second then of Kovac and Pisi. But jumping up to the front then, yes. Close that gap back into a chewing gum smelling range again. That's 14 and 15 that come around the final turn then.
Very, very close. Probably trying to overtake on this last mistake.
I'm just changing camera to the onboard shot for Kovac, as that's where the TV camera goes a bit bananas. Fizzy goes to the inside to defend. Kovac having a look around the outside, not close enough.
Really well, so.
Oh, that was close! Kovac managed to get his front right alongside Fizzy's rear left then. Trying to possibly pull a Fernando Alonso. Fernando Alonso has done an overtake through there. I think Kimi Raikkonen has in the past as well. But not this time. Well, look, Kovac is still so close. Fizzy's defending really, really well. We've seen so many brilliant defensive moves from Fizzy already this season. And we are seeing a great display. Oh!
And Fizzy made a little mistake there.
Oh, Kovac, there's actually a wandering wheel there somewhere. I can hear someone stuttering. There's a car with three wheels. There it is.
It's Stokman.
Oh, Stone. Wow. Wow, you identified that quick. Mine. And Kovac streamed past just as we were commenting on who that was. Kovac taking the lead. Brilliant stuff. Well done identifying who that was, Tony. Brilliant stuff. I haven't even got my hand on my arrow keys for until that point. So then, Kovac, in his first outing in the Formula Renault series, leads this race. Your pole sitter reclaims the top spot.
And now today wants to try the same overtaking Esteban Viso. Oh, and there was a little contact. Oh no!
Oh, I just clicked onto today as you said that. Oh, this could be interesting. Oh, that was close. One tire getting right in there. One tire back at the fourth place. He's going on the inside line there, trying to take Esteban. Not quite. Oh, I'm going to change camera here. Jump down the line. There's Manu, and there's a one tire going to the inside of Esteban Viso. Looks like he's got the speed to do it. Into turn one. One tire retakes third position. Does he? Yes, he does. Back to the TV camera then. Wow. Three-way battle here for third, fourth, and fifth. Oh, Esteban's gone wide. Esteban's gone wide into turn three. Manu goes back through into turn four. Position four into turn four. That's actually true.
Oh. Quite some shuffling up in the third to fifth position here in the last lap.
Absolutely. Worn tire currently holding third, but Manu is right on his gearbox now. Just going to chance having a look at the first and second. Oh, that's probably Stokeman's three-wheel car trying to limp his way back to the pits. That's turns 14 and 15. Looks like Kovac is opening a small gap between him and Fizzy. Wow, he really is getting the hammer down. But one small mistake from Kovac and Fizzy will make him pay for it. But is Kovac taking too much life out of his tyres? Only time will tell. I've tried to jump back to the third, fourth, fifth possession, and my camera doesn't know where to go. Right, we've lost Esteban Viso from this particular. Oh no, he's there. One tyre's gone wide into turn 13. So Manu.
Esteban might have problems with his tyres because he just went very slowly this lap. There was no obvious mistake.
Changing camera now. Esteban Viso is quite a way behind. Manu and Wontai just having a look at Manu. Too far back for an inside maneuver into turn one.
Just wanted to scare Wontai a little bit there.
Oh, good luck with that. I saw Wontai racing in the GT3 Pro category. He's not an easy man to spook. Looking at the first second battle now, it's Kovac has increased the lead ever so slightly, but. Again, not very much. They're catching now Flying Cayman. The back of a three-car chain of back markers now. Could this interfere with the lead battle? Will they get out of the way? No doubt there'll be certain words being said on TeamSpeak about this. There's not really any way he can get out of the way, to be fair, through 13, 14, 15 complex. Although, just as I say that, Cayman did manage to get out of the way of Govac. Oh, Fizzy did have to do a big dart out of the way there. Let's have a look
also
now.
Also, today definitely faster than one tire at this point in the race. We will see if he finds a lay-by or not.
I was just watching one tire. They looked like he was going to go wide there at turn 13, but managed to hold on to it. So as Manu and one tire come onto the start finish straight, one tire going to the inside. Manu had a much better drive out of the final turn, but I think they're just going to top out. Yeah, it sounds like they've topped out there. One tire's got the inside line. Manu is going to have to slot back into fourth place and try again later in the race. Change camera again. Viso on his own in fifth position now. DBZ Leica is a little way behind him, but can still see. DJ Ballistics on his own in seventh. Hideaki 4 in eighth. in eighth place. Was up to fourth earlier. Vice Guy in ninth position. The chief overtaker from his starting position, Francesco Sink, 29. Not someone I get to mention a great deal. Has made his way into the top 10 now. Back up to the front. Go back. Oh, Fizzy's made a mistake somewhere, or he's been held up by Batman, because as Govac's now got quite a lead over Fizzy. Oh, Fizzy spun! Fizzy spun on the exit of turn 16. Oh, he was very nearly hit there. Fizzy is waiting for a gap to appear in the back markers. Oh no, he's been hit! Oh, he's been hit! Oh, that is the end of Fizzy's race. Oh goodness me, I don't know who that was that hit him. It wasn't Tony R. Might have been Paradisky. I don't think Paradisky's actually moved all race or Dibdroid. Gibbs is also. I'm actually going backwards through the order. Gibbs is actually stationary in the gravel trap somewhere.
With that, we also missed the overtake from today over one tire.
Oh, so Manu managed to claim one tire for third position. Stokeman, Flying Cayman. I'm actually going back up the order to see who's still with us. IGC 2, 13th. El Nano is 12th. Stelling DK, we've seen some great things from him earlier this season. In 11th position, Mr. Soprano is now up to 10th place. Francesco Sink now up to 9th position after Fizzy's retirement. Vice Guy, now 8th. I think, is that him coming into the pits? Yes, it is. Vice Guy is coming into the pits. Might this be for a scheduled tyre change? Viso's just coming out of the pits, actually. Now in 7th place.
Yeah, I think those guys want to have new tyres. It's mid of the race now.
So that's a fair call. Hideaki 4 up to 6th position now. DJ Ballistics elevated to 5th. DBZ Machia now up to 4th. Warm Tyre, 3rd place. He's still in touch with Manu. Manu's not managed to get away a great deal.
And Manu today not having the best race today. He probably likes that Fizzy spun and is now DM.
Fizzy will not be pleased with that at all. But Govac on his own now as he's coming through the long turn 3. God crikey, Govac is quite a way ahead. Govac's coming through turn 4 as Manu today and Warm Tire just come out of the last turn. That's quite a considerable lead that Govac has for himself. And Govac's also set the lap record here, 127.993.
First race for the newcomer.
Crikey, I really hope we get to see more of this gentleman in future seasons. Manu, holding second place. Getting a bit of a gap now between him and Warm Tire. DBZ Leica. My camera's going mad again. DBZ Leica, a little bit on his own in fourth position. Ballistics. Ballistics is going through turn 1 and 2. In fifth, Hideaki 4. Got a back marker just in front of him. Sixth position, Esteban Visa. Seventh place, on his own, Francisco Sink. Whoops! That's bouncing over the apex of turn 14 there. Since I got to him in eighth position, Vice Guy. Still 9th. Stanley DK is in 10th position now. The field is relatively spaced out. I think that's Gibbs' stranded car. I just brought up the map there. I can see someone is stranded by turns 14 and 15. I think that's actually Gibbs. If I try and find him. Yeah, that's Gibbs that is still there. He decided not to return himself to the pit. He's decided to give himself an interesting spectator spot. Well done. Why not?
Maybe he wants to see the cut track violations. Chicane is known for that.
Oh, Manu is really opening a gap now back between him and Warntire. He's wanted to hang on to that second place. I'm sure he's really won in the first place, but Govac's on such a lead that Govac really could ease off with the seven laps remaining and probably keep hold of the lead.
Govac now 30 to 40 seconds ahead, so I would say if he drives slowly to the end, he has the P1 in the bag.
In the bag, save for bearing in mind we've not long seen Fizzy come very much unstuck from a spin at the last turn, and then being taken out by it must have been a backmarker. Anything can happen. I'm just taking a drink there, as my throat is rather sore. But never mind, needs must. We continue. So just gonna have a quick look through the order here. Govac on his own, coming through turn three. Does look like he goes slightly off circuit there, but I think that's relatively common for all four wheels outside the white line there. As he continues to bring down his lap time, he's not slowing down at all. I see his best lap 127.690 now. So he's
certainly not allowed to go with all four wheels beyond the white line. So if he does that consistently, he might get problems with the stewards later on.
That will be one to watch, because I have seen it a few times from not just Govac, admittedly. I've seen it a few times from other people, so we'll have to keep an eye on that. Manu really is beginning to get some distance now, getting into his own rhythm as he comes through turn three with Warntire not far behind, but is slipping back. Keeps it like a holding fourth position. Now he takes a very, very much tighter line through turn three, I'm just saying. Different drivers have different ways of taking respective corners. DJ Ballistics in fifth place. He comes up to turn one. Esteban Viso is closing in on Ballistics now, so we may have a bit of a battle there for fifth position between Viso and DJ Ballistics. Seventh, Hideaki Four. He's coming through turn 14 and 15. He's rather much on his own. Vice Guy holding seventh. He's just coming up to turns 14 and 15. And with just a few cars that came out of shot there, I think there may have been backmarkers. Oh, that was Manu lapping someone. Sterling DK, ninth position. Camera's getting lost again. Mr. Soprano just coming round, final turn, in tenth position. Francesco Sink. Where's that? Oh, there's turn 11. As I'm watching on board, I actually got slightly lost on where they were. Right, El Nano, 12th position. Just coming up to where I've just seen Francesco Sink go through. Flying K-Man. What's happened to him? Oh, he must have spun somewhere just off camera, because he suddenly appeared from inside the... what's that, turn 4, 5 or so?
I think he's spun several times this race already.
And he's just letting leaders through there as he's coming through turn 6 down to turn 7. So not been a great race. But Stokeman had a horrific day today. Really was doing well. Well into the top 10. Is now down in 14th place. IGT2, last time I looked at you, you were again within the top 10. So it could be pit stops or misadventures that have happened to him. Gibbs still... I think Gibbs is running again. Just so I say that, he spins. There's the commentator's curse kicking in once more. Gibbs is running again, but as he's coming through turn 12, but no sooner did I say it, he also spun. Diptroid, I think, is actually in the pits. Yes, he is. But along with Paradiski, Tony, Fizzy, and myself. Back up to the front.
I just rewatched the scene with Fizzy, and it looks like it was IGC or El Nano that hit Fizzy there straight on.
Well, both of those are still running, however.
That's really strange, but only those two guys were around him at the time.
interesting as it was such a major whack that Fizzy lost, I think, three of his wheels, certainly two of them, on the right side of his car. Kovac continues to dominate this race. He's coming through turn 10 as Manu is, he's just come out of turn 3. Nearly half a lap between those two drivers now. Wow. Did Kovac choose this race to come onto the scene, I wonder? Is he a Catalunya specialist?
And still fights going on with Spelling Decay around P9.
Worn Tire is on his own in third position. DBZ Leica, ooh, he's a little wide there in turn 5. But he's on his own in 4th. Esteban Viso in 5th place. He's lost that position. I was just thinking, who did he overtake? That's DJ Ballistics. He's taken off camera there for 6th position. Hideaki 4 in 7th place, just coming over the line. Vice Guy. Oh, then Steny, that's the battle you were just talking about. Steny DK and Vice Guy coming to grief at turns 14, 15. Steny DK's got a much better drive out of turn 16 and flies by four. I've got the wrong way. Flies past for 8th position now. But Vice Guy is not letting that go. Stelling's holding onto the inside line. He goes to the racing line. Vice Guy had a thing on the inside, but oh no, he took too much curb, lost too much traction, and is now losing time to Stelling. Try to switch back to the camera. Stelling holding 8th. Oh no, that's Vice Guy with a lapse runner. That's probably Manu that's coming up behind him. I think that was Gibbs that was just already behind Vice Guy. Yeah. Whoops! That's Vice Guy going slightly sideways there. That's probably Manu that's coming up behind Vice Guy.
That's Manu, that's correct.
Where is Vice Guy? There he is. My camera again going utterly crazy. Mr. Soprano rounds out your top 10 positions. Oh, and he's spun! The commentator's curse strikes again! I'm going to be very unpopular in these rear circles if this continues. That's down at turn 7.
You did that on purpose, I think.
Yes. What I actually have, my control pad is actually linked to every driver I can see. And as soon as I speak, I can pull the trigger and suddenly their throttle comes on, which causes them to spin.
It's magic.
So Mr. Soprano back underway. That's turn 10 that he's just at now. 11th, El Nano. Oops, just turned the nap off then. On his own there. Francisco Sink. 12th place. That is. That's just coming onto the straight between 9 and 10. There's Flying K-Man. It must be Mr. Soprano right in front of him. Or right behind him. and it's Flying K-Man had someone get out of his way then, I think. Stokeman. Still holding 14th. 2 laps to go now. I've been looking through the grid. Oh, IGC2 has decided to pit. So you may have been right, maybe an IGC2 that had that massive impact with Fizzy early on, because IGC2 has now pitted himself. Gibbs is still running in 16th, and the rest of the field, as we know, is out of commissions as Kovac has entered the last lap now. He's going through turns 1 and 2, down to 3. I wonder who that is that's getting out of... can't actually tell who that is getting out of Kovac's way there. Camera's going bananas again as we come through turn 4. Try and get my camera right again. Completely on his own there. See where Manu is. That's Manu just completing a lap there. As I bring up my map, we can see Kovac's just gone through turn 8. That's almost a half a lap between the two. And we know how fast today is, being one of the front runners in the series. Wow, I really am lost for words at the performance of Kovac in this opening round.
Especially after the mediocre start. Really fought back and now very nice lap times.
And there's nearly a full second between the fastest laps of Govac and today as well. But Govac is just coming through the 14 and 15. Here he is, round turn 16. Your race winner for the Circuit de Catalunya is a new guy, Govac. Here he comes, taking the checkered flag. Wow.
Good job.
Absolutely. Yeah, words are completely failing me at this point. And here we go, the silly season boots. The silly finishing positions now begin as DJ Ballistics comes up in second. Where's Manu? There he is. And Manu is coming through turn 12. He's very much away. Where's Paul Tyre? Oh, there he is. Where is he? He's fallen quite a way back from Manu as he's coming through turn 12 now, as today is just coming round. That's the final corner he's just coming down. So today is your second place finisher for this race. He'll be quite happy that Fizzy is out. Fizzy will not be pleased that his main championship rival has come home in second position. And here comes Warm Tyre in what I believe is his main race for the series as well. We've certainly seen interest from Warm Tyre in the last round. That's, I believe, Warm Tyre's first outing for Formula Renault 3.5, and he, too, is on the podium. Who else is still running? As I'm looking at DJ, Mr. DBZ Leica comes, comes across the line, taking fourth place. There's Esteban Viso claiming fifth place. DJ Ballistics, I think that may be right in him being sixth. I'm not 100% sure at this stage. It's difficult to tell. Vice Guy, looks like the Vice Guy's claimed seventh in all that's going on. El Nano, he's come across the line, so he's now registered in eighth. Mr. Soprano has claimed ninth. And Francisco Sink is showing his tenth place. He seems to be on a slowdown lap. So there we are. Your finishing positions are like so, as I bring up the list here. Govac is your race winner, with Manu is second. Warm Tyre taking the last of the podium places. Mr. DBZ like a fourth. Esteban Fiso 5, DJ Ballistics 6, Vice Guy 7, El Nano 8, Mr. Soprano 9, Francisco Sink 29, rounding out the top 10. Flying K-Man managed 11th in the end. Hideaki 4, after lots of misadventures early on, finished 12th. Stokeman, same for him, in 13th. IDC 2, after clouting Fizzy early on, is lost a good half the race there. I've just seen his lap count is down to 10, just 10 laps. Gibbs, I believe, was running at the end there. He's showing as 15th with Detroit. Paradiski and Fizzy showing as your retirement. Oh, just to add insult to injury, Fizzy's actually showing as disqualified. Just to add insult to injury.
So maybe he didn't retire manually, he just got a disqualification because of the hit, because of...
Because it was clearly Fizzy's fault.
he caused the collision, yeah.
That is a bizarre one. But there we are. Govac is your race winner. Still some people on track. How many seconds are still going? Oh, five. 5 seconds now until the race is complete. And there we go. We are done for the feature race here at Catalunya. And I shall hold my recording here. I shall return for the sprint race. Sprint race quali, I should say.